So God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus that you would allow your anointing to fall fresh in this house. Speak to us today, God. Empower us. Encourage us. Help us to recognize, Father God, that with faith we can do all things. But with faith, God, it is impossible to please you. Now, God, have your way in this worship celebration. Speak through me now, God. Help me to surrender myself to your will that you might do what's necessary, Father God, in order to let your people know that you are still in charge. God, thank you in advance for the yokes that are about to be broken. Thank you in advance, God, for the healing that's about to take place. Thank you in advance, God, for your word that is going to come now and lift our spirits and return the hope that some of us may have lost. We honor you, God, and we praise you, for it is in Jesus' name we pray. And the people of God say it. Amen, amen, amen. I invite your attention, my brothers and sisters, back to the 27th Psalm, verses 13 and 14. And that scripture reads, reading from the New King James Version of the scripture, that scripture reads, I would have lost heart unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Amen. Amen. And I want to tag this text this morning with the title, Being Defeated is Not an Option. Being defeated is not an option. My brothers and my sisters, as I was on vacation, we passed a place where the people who were not well off financially had been placed in this area because of their financial status. The community was a place where the citizens who resided there were given a mobile home, but the area did not have electricity, running water, or a sewage system. The guide on this tour informed us that after a period time, some of the residents went back to the government and told them they no longer wanted the mobile home and the land they had been given because the living conditions were atrocious and not conducive to a person living a normal life. They were willing to go back into a life where they struggled but yet had basic necessities to live a respectable life. They refused to allow what they had been labeled to keep them in a place that would not yield them any kind of life that offered them any way out. They refused to stay in a place of defeat and return to hope, hoping that a better life in the place they offered a little hope, a place where they could see their life turned around. They were ready to live a life void of defeat. They believed that they could see a better life in the land they had been extricated from than the land they had been given with no hope of a better life. Beloved, I want someone to understand today that life can be tricky. Life can deal you a bad hand. Life can turn your world upside down. But with the Lord, there is hope. Life does not have to make you want to give up. Life does not have to defeat you. But with the Lord on your side, life can change in a moment. And then you'll find yourself living a blessed and highly favored life. My brothers and my sisters, I stopped by today to tell somebody, don't let the lemons life give you sour you. Take the lemons and make lemonade. Yeah. Don't allow what the world throw at you make you think that you can't do better. Don't allow what folk throw at you make you think that you are what they say you are. Because the word of God declares and decree who we are and what we are and what we can have. And so rather than living in a defeated state, the word of God reminds me that I got victory. And so rather than being defeated, I choose to live in victory. Hallelujah. And so I want you to understand today that being defeated is not an option. The Psalm, the 27th Psalm is written by David. And it's written while he was under affliction. And some even believe that his life was in danger. But a common theme throughout the psalm was David's belief that he would make it through his situation because of his knowledge and relationship with God. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. This psalm is one where David knows who will protect him, who will provide for him, who will fight for him. This psalm, David recognizes and knows that the Lord will deliver him out of the midst of his troubles. My brothers and my sisters, we need to get to a place in our lives where we recognize and realize whatever we are going through is not greater than our God. We got to get to a place in our lives where we got this kind of radical faith that David had when he penned the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. We got to have a radical faith to know that no matter what life throws at us, the God that we serve has the ability and the power to turn any situation around. We got to recognize who our God is. So David understands who his God is. So when all of life's troubles came at him, he knew who to turn to. My brothers and my sisters, we got to have enough faith to know that when we turn to God, even though we don't see an immediate solution, God is still working. Because I'm reminded that the word of God said that all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord. Out of no ways. You got to understand that our God is still a healer. You got to understand that our God still provides. You got to understand our God still protects. No matter what you find yourself facing, our God is greater than what you face. Yeah, if my God can step out on nothing and just speak a word and things come into existence, you can't tell me he can't control what's going on around me. Matter of fact, the Bible declares that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. So whatever trouble is around us, my God can provide. He can take care of me because the world belongs to him. And even though the devil comes and tries to stir up some stuff, the God that we serve can put the devil in his place. And can I just go a step farther? If you really know who he is, you got the power yourself to speak to the enemy and make him go sit down. I just need about 15 people who can give God a praise right here, because when the enemy came upon you, God reminded you to speak and let the devil know you shall not have a victory here. You better tell the enemy that defeat is not an option. So David recognizes, he realizes that in the midst of all his troubles, just because of who it is he knows, he's gonna be all right. He recognizes that trouble don't last always. And the stuff that he was going through was not for him. God, I just said something right then. And see, so many times when we start going through stuff, we get comfortable in the stuff. But you got to recognize that's not your stuff. Why you say that, preacher? You remember when God had his meeting in glory and the devil walked right up in there talking about Job? And God said, you really don't know who he is, do you? You want to come at him, but you really don't know who he is. Go ahead and take some of that stuff that he got and watch he still bless my name. You see, even though Job found himself in the midst of a storm, he still recognize that God is able. And when we understand that our storms are not going to destroy us, but they will make you stronger, you began to look at them differently. You began to look at them like, wait a minute, maybe I'm doing the right thing. Because the enemy don't attack you when you're living right. The enemy don't have to attack you when you're doing what God asks of you. But the moment you decide, for God I live and for God I die, here comes the enemy trying to destroy what God has built up, trying to make you doubt who God is. But I don't know about you. If God gave it to me one time, he can give it to me again. How you know that, preacher? Come talk to me, Job. Job will let you know, I lost everything. I lost my children. I lost my wealth. I lost my health. But because I still have faith in God, because I still trusted in the Lord, when the storm passed over, I had double for my trouble. And I don't know about you, my brothers and sisters. I know God can replace. I know God can replenish. I know God can restore. I know God can renew. I know God can revive. I know God is able. Can I get a witness in here? Is there anybody here who thought you had lost it all, but God said, I still got you? Even though you're going through right now, I still got you. Even though it looked like you're losing, just hold on a little while longer, because when I get through with you, folk gonna wonder how you made it through, how you made it over. You should have gave up, but you still held your head up. Watch God do what he does, because being defeated is not an option. Yeah. David believed that he would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. David operates in faith. Even though my enemies and my foes come upon me to eat up my flesh, I will not stumble. Watch this. But they will stumble and fall. Hallelujah. They're not just going to trip, but they're going down, simply because they came at somebody who's anointed by God. Touch not my anointed. Do my prophet no harm. Yeah. So David is confident. David is confident. Though armies may encamp against me, my heart won't fear. Hallelujah. Because war can rise against me, but I'm going to be confident that the Lord is my light and my salvation. Hallelujah. Watch this. He's going to see me through it. He's going to give me direction. He's going to restore my vision. And then he's going to return what the enemy thought he had taken, because he's my light and my salvation. Y'all got to get that conjunction. But and that didn't, he didn't just say he's my light, but he said my light and my salvation. And see, with salvation comes more than just stored up to go to heaven. Salvation comes with healing. Salvation comes with blessing on top of blessing on top of blessing. Salvation comes with peace of mind. Salvation comes to remind you, even though the wind may be blowing, you shall not be moved. I just need about 20 people who will bless the Lord right now, because you know, because he's your light and your salvation, that being defeated is not an option. And so when I look at this text and I see David penning this, many people think because David is such a celebrated king that he never went through anything. But you don't know the life of David if that's what you think. David was anointed at a young age to be king, but he had to wait his turn. And in the midst of waiting his turn, the real king started to see something in the boy, and he got troubled by what God was doing through David. I want to help somebody here, because when God has his hands on you, folk who are not connected to God get troubled by you. Lord have mercy. And he was troubled by David. So King Saul at the time, when he used to get angry, watch this, David would come in and play music, and the music will soothe the anger. Look how God is working. As he's letting David get a glimpse of what the king does before he becomes king. God help me here. And so there was a time when the king and all of the grown men were afraid of the giant Goliath. But David walks down there as a young ruddy boy and said, what y'all scared of? David said, wait a minute. Y'all don't know the God that we serve, do you? Hallelujah. There are so many people around us who are afraid of the stuff that's going on because they don't know the God that we serve. David goes down there and he looks at the giant and he tells them, why are y'all afraid of that? I can imagine somebody say, you don't see how big the problem is. And David can look back at him and say, I see the big problem, but you don't know how big my God is. Hallelujah. And so David says, I tell you what, I'll go ahead and take care of the problem. King Saul say, okay, go ahead and take my armor and go down there. What he didn't recognize, watch this now, this is twofold now. He didn't recognize that he was trying to fit the future king. See, sometimes when folk trying to be funny, and sometimes when folk doing certain things, they don't know they're just looking out for the future. They don't recognize that the anointing that's on you is going to feel what they're trying to do anyway. And so he was just preparing him to wear that kind of armor when he becomes the king. But the second thing he didn't recognize is that that armor was his. Lord have mercy. The armor he tried to put on David was not fitted for David. And so David realized, this is your stuff, man. But what God has for me in due season, I'm going to get what he has for me. I don't want to put on your armor, but just give me 5 smooth stones and watch God does what he do. Watch God do what he do. And so he goes out, my brothers and my sisters, puts his hand in the fire. It takes out a smooth stone, get the sling and begin to sling it, and let the rock fly, and down goes the giant. Hallelujah. And when the giant went down, everybody started celebrating David. And when they began to celebrate David, the king got jealous. Hallelujah. And so as they go back home to the kingdom, the people are singing, Saul has slain his thousands, but David has slain his tens of thousands. That didn't go well with the king. Let me tell you, baby, you don't have to be jealous about somebody else's victory, because if you keep living, there's a victory coming your way. And so Saul was jealous, and he decided to kill David. David had to leave the kingdom and go on the run. Y'all think he was just all that because he became king and we celebrate, but David had to run for his life. And so many times, even though the Lord say he's a man after his own heart, David made some big mistakes in his life. He slept with Bathsheba, tried to get a husband to go sleep with him, and when that didn't happen, had her husband put to death, put him on the front line and told the fighting men to back off. God help me here. Treachery is something else. You better watch who you're running with, because everybody ain't for you. David didn't always have an easy life. He had a son, and when the son was born, he was born sickly, and the young boy died. David prayed and he prayed. He prayed and he prayed, but the young boy was not saved. But when it was all over, he stopped crying and recognized God is still God. And so I want you to understand, we celebrate David for his kingship, but David went through some stuff. David lived a life where he could have been, I'm defeated, I'm giving up, but he held on trusting the Lord. And so I want us to understand, just because you go through some stuff, don't mean that it's the end. Matter of fact, that was just the beginning. And I need somebody to understand, the stuff that you're going through, the stuff that you've been through, just getting you ready for your next breakthrough. Just getting you ready for your next blessing. The stuff you're going through is preparing you for what God is getting ready to do in your life. If you never had a test, you don't have a testimony. If you've never gone through anything, you don't know how good he is. If you've never been sick, you don't know he's a healer. If you've never been broke, you don't know he can provide. If you've never gone through the storm, you don't know he will cover you. You got to understand, you got to go through some stuff every now and then just so you can be reminded that God promised me, I never leave you, nor will I forsake you. God promised me, I'll be with you always, even to the end of time. God promised me that I will take care of you. God promised me I will provide your every need. I don't know about you. I might not be able to eat steak sometime, but peanut butter and jelly will give me some substance. Somebody got to understand, God will provide if you just trust him. So David here in this text shows a faith like never before. And so I want you to understand, my brothers and my sisters, this text shows what our faith reveals when we are faced with life situation. The first thing in this text that I want you to understand is faith resists our emotional defeat. God is saying to you, don't let your emotions get the best of you. Some of us are losing out because we're letting our feelings get involved. I feel defeated. Stop talking about that stuff. The power of life and death lies in your tongue. And if you speak defeat over yourself, you will be defeated. So get out of the emotional defeat and learn how to walk by faith and not by sight. Learn how to trust the fact that God has told you he is with you. You see, the Bible says, I would have lost heart unless I had believed. The emotional thing is I would have lost my heart. The stuff that was going on around me was so serious that I would have given up. I would have thrown in the towel. I would have laid down and died. Don't you remember when Elijah was going through the city and he runs into this lady who's a widow, has a child, and decides, I'm going to cook this last cake. Me and my son going to eat, lay down, and die. But the man of God comes by and say, wait a minute. I need to exercise a little faith here. Go ahead and cook me a cake first and then cook. But I only got enough for me and my son. But if you do what I told you to do, you won't run out of meal and you're going to have enough for you and your son, not just for today, but for the times to come. And when she did it, she had more than enough simply because she stepped out on faith. She got off of her emotional roller coaster and stepped out on faith, and faith saw her through a difficult time. Don't allow your emotions to cause defeat. Stop all of the crying. Start praising. Hallelujah. I know sometimes it seems hard not to cry, but I promise you, if you get just enough strength to start saying, Lord, I thank you, the tears of sorrow will turn into tears of joy, because you will recognize that he's still in charge. He's still able. And then you will stop and you'll look, wait a minute, even though I'm going through all of this, I still haven't missed a meal. Even though I'm going through all this, I might can't pay them all at the same time, but my bills keep getting paid. Even though I'm going through all of this, my emotional distress is coming down simply because I know he is a provider. I know he will make a way. I know he's able to open up the windows of heaven, pour me out a blessing that I won't have room enough to receive it. I'm getting off of the emotional roller coaster and I'm getting here on faith. I'm walking by faith. I'm like Peter. I'm getting out the boat, walking on the water. I'm trusting God that in the midst of this storm, he's going to see me through. I would have lost heart unless I had believed. And so
The first thing in the text is faith resists our emotional defeat. The second thing is faith reveals our expectation of victory. Watch this now, watch this. I would have lost heart unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. God help me here. He's saying to us here in the second point is, I don't have to wait to get to heaven to enjoy the blessings of the Lord. But I believe that I'm going to have victory right here. I just need somebody to understand that in the midst of your struggle, you got to keep thinking, I got victory still. In the midst of your storm, you got to keep speaking victory in your atmosphere. Because I don't know about you, but the atmosphere that's bringing storms can't penetrate the atmosphere that you got faith in. God help me here. Even though it's raining around you, it can't penetrate you to a point where you give up on God. I know some of you have gone through some trials, but your faith is what got you through it. The devil came at you every way he could, but you kept trusting God gonna see me through this. The devil tried every trick he knew, but you kept saying, God gonna see me through it. And every time the enemy came at you, God was already showing you what he was getting ready to do. I wish I had somebody who understands. God won't let it sneak up on you. He'll begin to show you that things are happening and get yourself ready. Can I help somebody? Sometimes you all of a sudden you get this feeling something is not right. I don't know if you've ever been there. You get this feeling something seems like it's out of place. All of a sudden, folk who would be there for you seem to back away, and you're wondering what's going on. And then you start to experience little things all around you, and you wonder what in the world is going on. And before you know it, the enemy show his hand. Lord have mercy. He shows up and he starts to stir up some stuff. But what he didn't recognize is I had already started praying. Because the moment I got that bad feeling, I started praying. The moment that thing started troubling me, I started praying. See, I had already covered myself before he can even show up. Because God was preparing me that something wasn't right. He didn't tell me exactly what it was, but the spirit that he gave me reminded me, if you just listen to him, you know something is going on. Have you ever had to get up at night? You were sleeping soundly and all of a sudden God shook you. You had to get up and get on your knees and call on the Lord. You didn't know why he showed you so and so in the dream, but you began to call their name. You don't understand why all of a sudden you began to hear a certain name, but you went to God on their behalf. And when they came back and talked to you, they told you, I was going through so much and didn't know how I was going to make it. And then you look back and say, that's why he had me praying for you. You got to understand, God will drop something in your spirit. And when he drops a name, don't just hear the name, pray for the name, because you don't know who you're interceding for. But God can do a miracle work if you just believe. So here it is. Let me get back. Here it is. He said, I would have lost heart unless I believe that I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I expect victory. I expect that God is going to see me through these trying times. I expect that God is going to make ways when doors have been closed. I expect that God is going to shield me when the enemy is coming against me. I expect that I got the victory in the midst of all the defeat around me. Walk to the right, there's defeat. Walk to the left, there's defeat. But if I walk straight, God, help me here. There's nothing but victory in front of me. The devil's trying to push you off the path to victory and trying to push you in the pile of defeat. But I stopped by today to tell somebody, don't lose focus. Don't lose your vision. Keep trusting in the Lord. Keep walking by faith, and you will walk into your victory. Can I get a witness in here? Is there anybody here who found themselves in the stench of defeat, but you began to speak victory over yourself? You refused to allow what the enemy was doing to bring you down. You kept trusting God in spite of what you saw. And after a while, God showed you some light. He reminded you, because you didn't give up, because you didn't waver, because you kept moving, I'm about to bring you through. I know it's dark right now, but look over there. Just beyond that cloud, the sun is beginning to shine. You see a little bit of the victory, and now you got happy feet because you're ready to get there. You refuse to stand still. You refuse to give up. You refuse to stay anchored. You told the Lord, bring me through this, and I'll praise you. And I wonder, anybody here got a praise because you expected victory, and God gave you the victory. Say yeah. He said, I was going to see the goodness of the Lord. Hallelujah. In the land of the living. Hallelujah. The devil could do all he want to do, but the goodness of the Lord, that's going to be mine in the land of the living. God reminded me, you shall live and not die. I'm going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. God reminded me, everything the enemy took, I'm about to replace and give you some more. You're about to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I wonder if anybody in here believe that you're going to see his goodness. You're going to receive his goodness. His grace and his mercy is about to restore. His grace and his mercy is about to turn it around. His grace and his mercy about to give you a new outlook. His grace and his mercy about to give you a shout like it never had before. Because what was dead, God said, now it's alive. What was buried is now getting up, because I'm not done with you yet. I got more for you. And when I give you more, don't you keep it to yourself. You go tell somebody, look what the Lord has done for me. Look where he brought me from. Hallelujah. I was down, but I wasn't out. And now I'm up, and I got to praise him. David's faith revealed that he expected victory in the land of the living. And then finally, faith restarts our encouraging testimony. After he realized, I'm going to get this victory. See, y'all missed that. David knew, I'm getting this victory. Watch this. Not if I get the victory, but when I get the victory. Because he said, I believe that I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. He was reminding us that I'm about to get it. Hallelujah. Not if I get it, but I'm going to get it. And when I get it, I'm going to turn to my brother who's going through. I turn to my sister who's going through and tell them, even though you're going through the storm, just wait on the Lord. Don't get in such a hurry that you miss out on what God is doing. Just wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. Hold on, because you're about to receive yours too. I might get mine first, but just understand my blessing might be a preview of your blessing. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and in the midst of your storm, he shall strengthen your heart. God help. Not he might strengthen, but he shall strengthen your heart. He's going to give you the courage to hold on. He's going to give you the strength to fight on. He's going to give you the unction to move on. He's going to let you know, keep going, because your blessing is also on the way. And so now that I receive my blessing, I got to encourage my brother and sisters. If he'll do it for me, he'll do it for you. I just want you to wait just a little while longer. Don't give up right now. You're so close to your breakthrough. Don't give up right now. You're so close to your deliverance. Don't give up right now, because the window is already cracked. You feel the breath of air of your blessing. How you know that, preacher? Because you ain't crying every day no more. Hallelujah. You're not giving up every day. But all of a sudden, every now and then, I can hear you say, Lord, I thank you. In the midst of your trial, you're saying, Lord, you're so good. In the midst of your trial, you tell it, I'm not giving up. And all of a sudden, the crack, the window keeps on moving up. And after a while, because it's your time, the window's going to open up and the blessing's going to pour in, because you didn't give up. I got to encourage somebody, don't give up and don't give in. Just like he blessed me, he'll bless you. Can I get a witness here? Is there anybody here who got a testimony? Look where he brought me from. When the doctor gave up on me, here it is, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, I'm still here. When my money was looking funny, everybody thought I would fold, I still got a car. I still got a house. I still got clothes on my back. I still got food to eat. He didn't let me down. But I'm glad that I waited on the Lord. And when I waited, he blessed me beyond measure. He blessed me with so much that I could bless somebody else. And so I got to tell somebody about the goodness of the Lord. Look where he brought me from. A little boy born in a house of 7 children, only 2 bedrooms. We all share one bed. But look what the Lord has done now. Got my own house, and my children had their own bedroom. Look at what the Lord will do. Look now, used to have to depend on somebody else to take me here and to take me there. But the Lord has blessed me. I got my own car. She got her own car. They got their own cars. Can't tell me what he won't do. Won't he do it? Yes, he will. He's all right. Yes, he is. And I got a testimony. He's been so good to me. Say yeah. Say yeah. God has been good. And I made up my mind, being defeated is not an option. Not when God already told me I got victory. Hallelujah. So why will I give in and let the enemy make me think that I've lost, when God has already said, you'll be the first and not the last? When God has already told me you're going to be blessed in the city and you'll be blessed at home, why would I feel defeated? Yes, stuff might be happening all around me, in my life, through my life, over my life. But God has said, even with all of that stuff, you still got the victory. He reminds me every morning, if I woke you up, you still got victory. Hallelujah. I know things may not be where you want them right now, but God is saying, wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. He will strengthen your heart. Then David said one more time, just for good measure, wait, I say, on the Lord. Hallelujah. There was a song back in the day that said, you can't hurry God. Hallelujah. And when you understand you can't hurry God, but if you just wait on him, what he has for you is going to be so much sweeter than if you had rushed him. Have you ever needed some and the store didn't have it, but you were going to make it happen some kind of way and you rigged something up? And when you tried to use it, it fell apart, ruining everything that you were trying to do. Sometimes you just have to wait. Stop trying to rush God. You don't want God to get in the place where he say, okay, I'll let my permissive will take place over your life. I've told you wait. I've told you no, but you keep asking. You keep doing stuff trying to get it. I'm going to let you have it, and you're going to see that if you had to just listen to me. And then when you get it, you're like, I should have waited. So just wait on the Lord. Understand, my brothers and my sisters, what we are experiencing right now is temporary. And you got to speak into your own atmosphere and begin to believe it in your own heart that being defeated is not an option. You got to remind the devil, I'm not laying down and handing you victory when God already told me that the battle is his. And if I just wait, we're going to see you get knocked out. Trust in my brothers and my sisters. Believe God and you're going to see that being defeated is not an option. He's going to help you control your emotions. He'll help you to understand and you'll begin to expect victory. And once you get that victory, you won't have no problems encouraging others. Hallelujah. My brothers and my sisters, the reason some of us don't know what I'm talking about right now is because we've not made that connection with God. We've not accepted Christ as Lord and Savior, and we're trying to go through life on our own. When you try to go through life on your own, when life happens, you don't know which way to turn. But when you know him, when you're connected to the Lord, when life starts happening, when things start acting up, when the enemy start coming against you, you turn to God and God say, okay, I'm going to keep you. Hallelujah. Watch this. It gets hard, but God say, trust me. Because when I get done with the enemy who's coming against you, and when I restore everything that he thought he had taken from you. And just understand this. If something is taken and you can't get it back, that meant it wasn't yours or it was just for that season. But when God said, but that's yours, he said, I give it back to you. But when I give it back to you, I'm going to give you a shine of your model. He's going to be better than what the enemy thought he took. God is getting ready to do some amazing things in our lives. But if you're not connected to him, you're not going to be able to understand what's going on. So I want to give somebody an opportunity, if you haven't done so, to come and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Get connected to the right source so that when life happens, you know who to turn to. So if you're here in the sanctuary or if you're watching online, if you've not accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior, this is a wonderful opportunity for you to do so. Secondly, if you're here today and you've not accepted, well, if you're here today and you want to recommit yourself, you accept the Christ as your Lord and Savior, but something drove you from the church, something drove you from his care, from his love, and you want to come back, just like the prodigal son after he had went and spent all and recognized that I had it better at home. When you've known the Lord and you get outside of his realm, you began to understand I had it better when I was with the Lord. If you are like that right now and you want to recommit your life to Christ, come on. And then thirdly, if you're here and you need a church home, Fountain opens his arms and say, you're welcome in this place. So we extend the threefold invitation, those who want to be born again, those who want to recommit their lives, or those who are looking for a church home. As we stand to our feet, will you come? Amen, amen, amen. To God be the glory for the great things he has done, is doing, and will continue to do. Amen. We prepare our hearts now to worship through giving, as we prepare to give as God has blessed us to be able to give. Our ushers are going to move through the sanctuary to receive your gifts at this time.